Hi there, welcome back to the Holy Comforter Episcopal Church YouTube Bible Study. I'm Jimmy Abbott, the priest here at Holy Comforter. I took a couple weeks off for Christmas, New Year, so you didn't get this video, but I'm glad to be back at it. Happy 2020, blessed Christmas and Epiphany to all of you as we get started. And we are going to kick off with this Sunday, January 12th. It's the Feast of the Baptism of Our Lord, which is always the first Sunday after the Epiphany. And so we'll read from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 3, verses 13 through 17. I just want to read some of this. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?" But Jesus answered him, "Let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness." Then he consented. I think this is important. John is saying, like, hey, Jesus, like, wait a second. You are far more important than I am. What's this all about? I think John is saying, I'm the one who is sinful. You're the one who is sinless. How is this thing working out? Now, I think what is going on here is a little bit of foreshadowing of the cross. Jesus, who is life himself, will surrender himself, will be obedient even to death on a cross. And I think that is foreshadowed here, and that the one who is all righteousness is submitting himself to sin, to death. And of course, though, the Christian story doesn't end there, right? That righteousness overcomes sinfulness, and that life will overcome death. And I think that's why we see Jesus, who is descends into the waters of baptism in the River Jordan, and then is also raised up again. And it has only been when he's raised up again that the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, it says, descends like a dove upon him. And that's when Jesus hears a voice from heaven. This is verse 17. "This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased." So I think that's kind of some of what's going on here, is that that role reversal, that the greater is submitting to the lesser, even though in the end that will be reversed. So I think there's some stuff for us in here to ponder. In a world that always tells us to accrue more power for ourselves, to have more titles, to have more important titles, or more educational degrees, and that those are the things in which by which we rank ourselves or tell ourselves how important we are. We see God in Jesus Christ submitting himself to something that's lesser. And I want to say that about the world. The world has always been doing that. That's not like a modern critique, right? I mean, that's like, that's just humanity, is that we're always trying to create more, gain more for ourselves. So part of the question maybe for your reflection is, what does it mean to submit yourself? What does it mean to lay something down for the sake of the greater good? What does it mean maybe, rather than trying to get more for yourself in the short term, to give yourself away for the welfare of others in the long term? Those are some of my reflections for you on this Feast of the Baptism of Our Lord. We'll be celebrating baptisms here at Holy Comforter. Always a great time to see, in this case, children and an older child too, one who will be making promises on his own behalf to say that this is the life he wants to live, and that we trust that as he comes up from the waters of baptism, the Spirit of God will also dwell upon him, and that those words will also be spoken over him: "You are my Son, my Beloved." So again, happy Epiphany, happy 2020 to all of you. I'd love to hear from you, and I'm so glad to be back doing these videos with all of you. God bless.